Earth's magnetic field varies continuously, both in time and space. Magnetotellurics is a geophysical exploration technique that measures electrical properties of the Earth. We can identify conductivity pathways or fluid pathways that may be related to these deep features in the Earth and how these features can be linked to mineral deposits. Resistivity data are then used to interpret and create geological models of the subsurface. Magnetotellurics as a technique has given us the unique perspective of what lies beneath the basement.
The variation in the magnetic field is not just generated from the rotating core. We're looking at magnetic activity which is coming in from solar storms, coming from lightning strikes all around the Earth all the time. And as the magnetic field travels through the Earth, it's creating electrical currents. And our instruments can pick up the really subtle variations, even from lightning strikes on the other side of the Earth. Rocks have a range of solid chemistry, as well as density and magnetic properties. They also have electrical properties. They're either very electrically conductive or really resistive. Rocks that perhaps have water in them, rocks that have metals in them, they're going to be really, really conductive. An MT system, it's more than just a single instrument. We have some magnetometers, we have some electrodes placed out in the field, facing north-south, facing east-west. They're constantly measuring the magnetic field of the Earth, building up a time series of data. All of this feeds into the data logger, which is taking a profile of measurements. If we have 1,000 Hertz data for a short amount of time, we might be able to see roughly around 10 metres deep. However, we want to look deeper than that, so we need to have a long, long period of data. We'll leave the instruments out overnight, over a week, even over several months. We're looking at very long wavelength changes. That gives us an idea of what's happening a lot deeper. We're talking hundreds of kilometres. We know a lot of the mineral deposits out there are the result of the flow of fluids underground coming up from the mantle. And this is where MT excels. It can look at the fluids as well as the metals. It sees that fluid flow at very deep levels up to very near surface. And that's a key bit of information for the mineral industry. What we're looking at now is scale reduction. We're taking new measurements in between the old ones, collecting more data, more detailed resolution, higher computational power, and more data means we move from the two-dimensional space where we've collected a transect of data, and we expand that out into the 3D world. We get better resolution of data, the electrical conductivity underground. We get the ability to bring in other data sets, other geophysical techniques that complement each other, and we can combine it all together and build up a holistic model. And this is where the future is. People in the AI and the machine learning world, they like big data. Well, we've got big data and we're getting even more of it. With this sort of instrumentation, with this kind of field work, we can start to build up a picture of what's happening very deep underground and generate new targets, which is what the mineral explorers will be really interested in.